Hi guys, welcome back to the Precious Reality. Let me tell you how everything in my life is just a twist. Like, oh, there's so much more that I feel. I won't stop until I uncover. Ooh. Oh my gosh. Hi guys, how are you guys doing? I really hope you're well. Thank you for clinging. Thank you for clicking on this video. Please, please stay. Watch the video until the end. I really, really appreciate you so much. And for those of you guys who are new to the channel, welcome to the Precious Reality. Like, it's chilled over here, okay? Join the family, subscribe, like the video if you like the video, and also comment and share the video, okay? Please, it helps the channel a lot. For those of you guys who are coming back, you keep on coming back and coming back. Thank you so much. We really appreciate your support on this channel. Please keep it up, guys. We cannot do without you. We can't do without you. Okay, so today, you guys can see I'm dressed in, like, I'm dressed in semi-formal or formal, whatever you wanna call it, because I'm just I just got back from the office, so yeah. I just decided I have this energy going on. I don't know. I just feel so energetic today, so I just wanna shoot this video today. And this is one of the videos I had planned to do on the series. So today I'm going to be telling you guys a story time. This is basically just a story time of how I always planned and God decided. Let me tell you how everything in my life is just a twist. Like, everything happened as it should. I'm very grateful to God for everything that happened. But if I tell you that I did not see my life or myself where I am today, and I actually looking back, I wouldn't have it any other way. I honestly just love my life right now. I thank God for bringing me to this state, because I honestly cannot imagine myself elsewhere. How crazy is that, guys? How crazy is that? I know when we grow up, we all have different aspirations, we all have different dreams. We want to be something in life, and you know, what something that you want to be is not always what you will be. You need to be very aware that it's not everything in life that you plan that will come, that will happen, that will go according to your will. Especially if you're a child of God, if you pray to God, if you're a believer and you pray to God that, God, every day you pray, let your will be done in my life. You must just remain very, very happy with where you are, because you are literally living in your answered prayers. When you pray to God every day, you grow up praying this prayer that, God, let your will be done in my life. And your will may not be God's will. I mean, God's will might be very different from your own. I mean, God knows what's best for us, okay? Without wasting any more time, guys, let's get into the story. So growing up, right? Growing up, I was never really a top student in school. I've always been an average student. For those of you guys who watch Gift's channel or who watch this video, I posted a link of the video where Gift was interviewing me on her channel about my journey and how I ended up into auditing from a computer science background, right? For those of you guys who already saw it, that's great. But if you haven't, and also I feel like I wasn't that detailed in that video, so if you want to get more details, you can stay on this one, and yeah, you'll know everything today, okay? I don't know why I'm so energetic, guys. I'm literally weird. It's so weird. Okay, so let's start from the beginning. As I was saying, guys, that growing up, I was never a top student. I had to work my butt off for the marks that I want, for the results that I want. Like, I had to work extra hard, you know? If everybody there, those people who work who work to get the results. This is me. Like, I'm a product of people who work for what they want. Like, nothing comes easy. You know, we have geniuses, people who just they grasp very easily in class. Like, it comes easily to them. You know, when they're studying, they don't have to go so hard. It's just chilled vibes, you know. And there are those ones like us who work very, very hard, who study very, very hard. I know everyone studies hard, but let's be fair, they are those ones who are very smart, like who are born smart. And like my sister, like, reality, she didn't have to study as much because she is just naturally intelligent. She's naturally smart like that. Like, she doesn't forget everything that she's taught in class. She can literally write a test just based on what she's taught in class. Some of us though have to, like, yes, we listen in class, but we still have to go back home and study. Like, go back and revise, study, revise, and, you know, for everything to get into this thick skull, okay? Yeah, but my point is, growing up, I worked really, really hard, especially in school, for my results. If I tell you guys, I love maths personally. Those of you guys who know me know this. Maths is my favorite subject. It's always been my favorite subject, especially in high school, right? So, yeah, I struggled a lot with maths my whole high school years. When I got to grade 11, maths was the pit. Like, okay, I didn't really struggle as much. I would get 50s, like, you know, around there when I was in my grade 8, 9, 10, 11. Guys, grade 11, that was when Sir Charles came. Grade 11 maths was not playing with me, chum. It was hitting me hard. Like, I would even get excited if I get a 30% in the exam or even in the test. Like, it was that deep. Like, you would feel like you could never pass that maths. It was so difficult. And then matric came. Yeah, I worked very hard in matric, guys. I don't wanna lie. I had sleepless nights. I studied myself to sleep, you know. Yeah, but thank God that I managed to pass. Like, I passed with a bachelor's degree. This is my proudest moment. I cannot emphasize it enough. I get it, I have a degree. I get it, I have an honors degree, whatever. But my matric, guys, you don't understand just how it makes me so proud. Like, for me to know that I passed matric, that year was not an easy year. Personally, financially, physically, everything else, it was not. Emotionally as well, it was not an easy year for me. So for me to come out of that situation with those results is very, 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 it's remarkable. It's outstanding. It is mind-blowing. Like, my mom should come here and testify how hard that year was for me. But your girl managed to pass. I made it and I'm here, okay? So I guess the main message of this is that I haven't even gotten to the real story.
What?
How? Hold on, bro. How?
So, okay. So in high school, I wanted to be a dentist. Like, you know, when you're a science student, when you're a science learner in school, and you're always like, you know, most of us wanted to be doctors. Like, you just have to choose which specialist you want to be, okay? I just decided to be, I found dentists very cute. Like, you know, dealing with teeth for the rest of your life, that's super cute. It's not as hectic as being a surgeon or being a gynecologist or being, like, you know, all those other things, but dentists just seemed so cute to me.
Stop it, get some help.
It'll be so cute, you know. Yeah, so I saw myself as that. I chose the sciences as my modules, as my subjects in school. I did that. I pushed myself so hard. But you know, the marks were not maxing. Like, the marks were not maxing for me to study medicine or to study, like, anything in health sciences, you know. And at the back of my mind, I'm just like, okay, I'll either be a dentist or a pharmacist, you know. A pharmacist was something that was trending back then. It was like the it course that you know, if you are smart, you do it, you become a pharmacist or something like that. I don't even know why it was a thing, but hey, it was. I don't know if it's still a thing now, because now it seems like everyone just wants to be in IT, tech, whatever, you know, which is a good thing, because I mean, innovation, honey. Like, we are moving into a more digital world, so we obviously need more specialists in that field. But your girl marks, your girl passed her matric with a bachelor's degree. You see that bachelor that you can see that, huh? It's God's grace. You see that bachelor where you can just feel like, oh my God, Jesus, thank you. Like, guys, honestly. And then, okay, my dad, guys, I just want to thank a shout out to my dad. Like, I don't even know if he watches my channel. I don't think he does. But like, that man, guys, my dad was very supportive. So when I finished my matric, he was literally holding my hand, guys. So he was helping me throughout. That's why I'm saying, Lord, I thank God that I had someone who was guiding me through that transition from high school to varsity, because I don't even think I would be in varsity if it wasn't for my dad, honestly speaking. So my dad helped me apply to universities, which is funny because I only applied at UL. I don't know why I didn't want other universities. I don't know. It's not that I didn't want them, but I only applied at University of Limpopo. Which is funny because, child, how can you put your eggs in one basket? Like, that is so weird. Okay, but your girl applied at University of Limpopo, and then I applied for pharmacy. I applied for, what was my second option? I forgot what my second option was, but they're both health science courses, which is funny because my marks were not maxing. Okay, so come January, then obviously my dad paid for my application fee. He helped me with NSFAS, you know, all of those things. I think because I'm his firstborn, he was just so excited that his first child is going to university. And you know, it was a proud moment. Like, if you know my dad, you know that he is an education enthusiast. He loves education, he is for it, and he will make sure, one thing about him, he will make sure that his children go to school, and that makes him so, so proud. That's what I love about my dad. Like, he would make sure, like, when it comes to school, he does not come compromise. He will tell you, go to school, okay? Purr. Like, that man has a PhD, he's a professor. Like, you just don't want to finish school, my nigga. Like, rest. I'm kidding. So now I'm just like, oh, the pressure is getting worse. But anyway, so my dad helped me. I remember when we were going for registrations in January, like, okay, it's great, I've got a bachelor's degree, now I can go to university, because you know universities, you can't just go, honey, you must have a bachelor's. Okay, I was excited because, you know, this means I'm going to university. But little did I know that, child, like, you can't go to university and do what you want with those marks. Those marks are not giving. They're not giving at all. So in high school, we did math and mental aid. So I have math and mental aid on my matric certificate, right? Which helped a lot, because if your math marks are not giving, then your mental aid definitely will help you, because math lit is much easier. So I think my math lit, I got 60 something, was it 67%? I think around there. And then my math marks, final marks, were like 57%. Yeah, which is not bad at all, guys. Honestly, I just missed 60 by 3%. Look on the bright side. Okay, so cool, then I go to University of Limpopo. It's so full, it's so packed. I'm just like, oh my gosh, I just want to see myself. And I'm so excited, guys. I'm going to school, I'm going to university, I'm gonna work and make money. I'm so excited. Okay, so we get there, and there are long queues for days. My dad already knew his way around because he used to be a lecturer and he used to work at the university, so he knows his way around the university. So he took me to the queue where, like, pharmacy that was so funny. So where pharmacy aspiring pharmacists go, right? Cool. My dad is looking at my marks like, this child, she wants to be a pharmacist with those marks. But he's not telling me, he doesn't want to break my heart. He's not telling me that, my child, where you want to go, your marks will not take you there. Okay, but my dad is just quiet because I was so positive, guys. Pharmacy, like, you know, because I don't think there's dentistry at UL, so pharmacist was the normal school, which is annoying because why? I thought we're gonna do practical stuff. Of course there were like practical stuff, but like it's still not what I expected, you know. It's still the same expectations. Like when you transition from a varsity to a workplace, it's very different. Like that's the expectation I'm talking about. You guys will get it. The girls that get it, the girls that don't. Yeah. The girls that don't. But yeah, guys, cool. So we go to that department there. When we get there, I'm like, there's this lady at the door. She's like, oh, let me see a statement. Okay. She looks at my statement. She's like, okay, you qualify. You can do computer science. I'm like, girl, computer? You said computer. I don't like that. I don't like the sound of that. It's not giving, okay? She's like, yeah, computer science, you'll do physics. I'm like, screams. So yeah, in my head I'm just like, oh my god, I hated IT in high school just because I don't know, I just didn't like it like that, you know, which is weird because when I got to varsity, I loved it so much, guys. It's so weird. So I look at that lady, I'm like, I look at my dad, I'm like, yo, Baba, computer science in IT, I'm bored, like, I get right. And like, after registering, then my dad is like, okay, let's go, because I told him I'm hungry. He's like, okay, let's go and eat. He took me to Bitalitos. Yeah, there's Bitalitos in campus. high school who think that they know so much. Because one thing I noticed is, I talk about this a lot with my friends. I'm like, guys, do you realize that people who come from high school with high marks, like, you know, A students who do so well, they're always in the top 10, they do so well, they don't do well in varsity. And we ask ourselves why, because these people are smart. We know that they're smart, we know they work hard, obviously. Like, is it because they're tired, because in high school they used to work hard a lot? Or is it because they just feel like they know too much, they feel like it will be easy to pass? Or is it because, obviously, people will tell you that just work hard in high school, you don't have to work hard after matric, blah blah blah. You know how people lie to us, like, things will get easier from here, you're not gonna work so hard when you get to varsity, you can do whatever you like, just study hard now, you know. Those things that really, really are not true. You should start being honest, okay? Even teachers, because y'all be saying these things and we just get to varsity and we're like, what the freak is going on? Why? Like, why does it seem more difficult? And, you know, yeah. But anyway, guys, my point is that, like, it's very, very important in varsity to have friends who will help you pass. Because now I knew, whatever, like, if I was struggling in class, my friends were very smart. Like, I wouldn't leave the classroom if I don't understand something. I will make sure Gogi is there, Baju is there, Winza is there. They will help me. I will understand what's going on before I leave the class, like, all the time. And also, if I'm struggling, I would call my friends, like, girl, when I'm practicing stats or maths or whatever, I would call them, get a girl, like, explain what's going on, because I don't understand. They would explain. Life would be so, so much easier. Okay, now this is the frustrating part of my life, where things took a 10 for the worst. Not for the best, child. For the worst. But the worst, like, what I thought was the worst actually was the best, because it really proved me wrong, like, in a way, which is a good thing. Okay, I'll explain. So we are done. Let me tell you guys, all my friends left and I was the only one who didn't have a job after my final year. It was difficult to find a job, y'all. Like, it was so hard. I applied, but it wasn't working out. So I was like, you know what? I'm not gonna stay at home. Let me register for honors, right? Let me register for honors. And then I registered for honors, right? And then I did my honors, which I'm very grateful for. I'm very, very grateful that I did honors, because it literally brought me where I am. When I tell you guys that I did not even plan to study this computer science, but look at where I am today. I'm the happiest I could ever be. I'm so happy. I love my job. I'm so grateful I did computer science. Like, I enjoyed it. I loved it so much, né? So, okay, let me go back. Okay. So, where was I? My friends leave after 4 years. We were all doing the extended program, and they leave, they go to a different whatever. They went to different places, different, yeah. I decided to register. The final year, you have to choose. This is only University of Limpopo. I don't know about other universities. So you have to choose your majors. You can choose to major in two fields. So I chose computer science and statistics, man. So because you have two majors, you can do honors in either of them. So I applied for both. I applied for computer science honors and I applied for statistics honors, right? Okay, so deep down, I wanted computer science because I loved it. I enjoyed it more, and I felt like my career will be more aligned to computer science in a way. I just didn't know, but I just felt like it's more me. It's computer science. I'm really really, really depressed here. I don't feel like I belong here, you know? And I'm just like, oh my God, how can I move? Those formulas were frustrating me. I was just like, oh my gosh. I remember I wrote an email to the department there, computer science. I was like, I want to do computer science, please. Like, they told me it's full, but I really want to do computer science. I can't do this. I want to change. Like, please make a plan for me. Like, I can't. So then they really, really made a plan for me, guys. I moved. They gave me the acceptance letter for computer science. I was so happy. But this was weeks. I was behind with some lectures and schoolwork. They already had assignments. And yeah, I was so behind. But I managed to go. And then, yeah, fortunately for me, I found a supervisor as well. And I was so happy. Then I went to computer science. I felt so happy there. I was just like, I feel like I belong here, you know. I was excited. I was so happy. And I'm glad I did it. But let me tell you a twist, guys. Remember, I had friends during my 4 years. Like, these are the people who helped me every step of the way. That's why I would be proud to tell you guys that those girls made my whole degree, because I wouldn't have passed without them. I'm not even joking guys. I wouldn't be where I am if it wasn't for them inspiring me, motivating me, pushing me, you know. Like, they would be studying and I would just feel so guilty, because I'd be like, wow, what am I doing with my life, you know? I will study. But you would call me in the morning. That girl made sure she would call me and be like, girl, normally like library side, baby jalapoloa. So she would say, girl, jalapoloa in the morning. And I'll just feel so guilty. I will wake up and study, because I'm like, my friends are studying, let me study. I don't want to be the only. I had my own plans. I wanted to be a dentist. But down the line, when I'm sitting with myself and having a conversation with myself, I'm just like, girl, first of all, you don't like chemistry. Like, you don't like... Yo, guys, can you believe? Guys, can you believe that the camera stopped recording while I was busy? I don't even know how much information I missed, you guys. So let me just continue. Okay, so I will move from the varsity stuff, then I'll go to the work stuff, right? So I did research. I'm not as enthusiastic, as hyper as I was, because I'm just so bored. I lost all that information. Anyways, guys, so I was saying that I got